Well, I'm joined this afternoon by Sonny Monaghan, who has been cast in a rather epic and sort of timely musical called Dear Evan Hansen. You got this role by auditioning on TikTok. How did you
I
hear about
did.
that?
So I'm quite a big fan of the show, and around, I think it was February time, they announced a partnership with TikTok that they were looking to cast someone in their new production that was going on tour around the UK. And it was all they required was that you submit yourself singing a song from the show. And so I, as fast as lightning, recorded myself singing the song Words Fail from the show, and I uploaded it to TikTok. And a couple of weeks later, I received an email telling me I had an in-person audition. And then from then on, it was very much like your regular Central London musical theatre audition process. I did three rounds, and then about a month later, they offered me the job as the alternate Evan Hansen. So every matinee across the whole tour, I play Evan.
That's a fantastic role to land because this is your first major casting, isn't it?
Yeah, it's my first big professional job. I've done quite a few smaller professional acting jobs before, but this is obviously my first rather large part.
And you're from Eastbourne, I believe.
I am,
So
yes.
you're home for your performance in Brighton.
I am.
But I mean, this TikTok thing, I mean, you were one of thousands of people that applied.
Yeah, I think it was around, from what Natalie, the casting director, told me, I think it was around 2,000 or so people, maybe more, and 36 people got invited to be seen in person.
That's a pretty high stakes, high odds.
Yeah, it's a lot.
So you must have been absolutely blown away when you get the call to go and do the in person.
Yeah, I had been I'd gotten quite far with this show when it was in the West End, in the audition process for it. So when it got announced that it was coming back as a tour, I kind of assumed that I would have an audition for it anyway, and then that wasn't happening for me. So then, luckily, this TikTok aisle opened up, and I committed to it because I had faith that they would see that I personally thought I was quite good for the role. So,
Yeah.
and I think they thought the same, fortunately.
It's a difficult storyline, Dear Evan Hansen. It's not
Very.
a piece of fluff, is it? I mean, it is about
No.
teenage angst and depression, and
Yeah.
Evan falls into this terrible loop of deceit.
Yes. I think the way that I would describe it is it's obviously it's not fluff. It is hopeful. And all of the characters are very human and they're very real and flawed. And the story that it tells, I think, is relatable to anyone who could come and see it. It's not got an age specificity. As much as the story centers around the teenager, there are really strong storylines that are related to the adult characters. And I think it would suit any age group coming in to see it.
I've only seen the film. I missed it in the West End, sadly. And I've only seen the film. The film was very disappointing.
That's that. Our production, however, isn't.
It isn't the film either. No, it's obviously you're playing the alternate lead role, which means, as you say, you're doing the two matinees every week. But is there a
Yes.
temptation to slip something into the drink of the person playing him on the nights so that you get to go on?
No. I think the last thing I would want to do is do this every night. That character every night. For one, the sing is outrageously difficult,
Yes.
notoriously difficult. And I even me doing it three times a week get quite tired about it. Two or three times a week get quite tired about it. And also, Ryan is phenomenal. We're both, and I'm very happy that he gets to do it six times a week. It's really a dream to share it with him as much as, and people always say that they're like, oh, maybe just like a little push down the stairs so you get to go on more. No, I really, I'm honored to be covering him because he is phenomenal.
Also, you're in the ensemble on the
I
nights that
am.
you're not singing, Evan. So you've got two parts to learn. I mean, that's double
Well,
work, isn't it?
yeah, I so I'm the ensemble, I cover Evan, but then I'm also the second cover for two of the other principal characters. So I have a lot on my plate. It is
That's four
rather
roles to learn.
four roles, yeah. Yeah,
That's
it's a
a
lot,
lot.
but it's yeah, it's but it's gonna be great. I'm excited to do the others as well. Now that I've done Evan quite a few times, I'm excited to get my teeth into the other two.
And how's it going on the tour? Is it going down well?
Yeah, I mean the audience reception's been brilliant. Everyone's really, really enjoying this new production, this new take on the show, kind of. Nothing really has changed about the script. Maybe minor things have changed. It's just staging and set and stuff like that has changed, and it's really interesting seeing the fans of the show come back and see it looking a bit different and sounding different because it's an ensemble, and just hearing all the reactions. But it's all been very positive so far, and we've just made our first move into Leicester Curve, and we're here for our first day today, and I'm very excited. It's gorgeous theatre.
Beautiful, isn't it? It's a beautiful
Yeah.
theatre. I think this is a tough show. I think it sailed on those fabulous songs and those amazing performances, obviously, by Ben Platt. But does it hold together as a story without the songs? I mean, some musicals are totally song-led and some
It's really
are
funny that you say that.
story-led.
Yeah, it's really funny you say that because on our first day in Nottingham, first day of rehearsals, we read through the script without any of the music. And it really does stand alone as a play because it's written, the book is written so well that it does stand without any of that music that's there. And it just elevates it so much because I think, as we all know, the soundtrack for the show is phenomenal. Like Pascal did a outrageous job on this. And yeah, I think either way, it would work as a play and it works as a musical. It just heightens the emotions, the music.
And you say this is not the West End production. This is a totally new production, new sets, new costumes, new direction.
Yes.
Is it very different from the show you saw in the West End?
I would say so. I mean, at least in the character of Evan, I think direction, Adam Pemford's direction has taken the character not in a different direction. I think it's just we found a more real Evan. I feel like it's playing more into him having social anxiety, and it's less, because I feel like with the original production, Evan was it was far more heightened, and it was more maybe like he had like twitches, or it was like the and that was kind of identify the character. I mean, our take, I feel like it's, and I feel like Ryan and I both have this, it's returning to him thinking his hands are sweaty and wiping down the sweat, and it's returning to that mindset of it's someone with social anxiety. Yeah, so it's,
So it felt more real characterization.
yeah, real, more. I feel like it might be that slight bit more realistic.
Yeah. So this is a major role. I mean, where do you go from here, Sonny? What are your dream roles to be moving on to playing?
I think the funny thing is, I think Evan Hansen was my dream role for my age that I was, for the age that I'm at. But I think I'd love to be in Book of Mormon. I mean, I'd love to do plays. Like, I think I'd love to play Christopher in The Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime. That's
Yeah.
probably up there. Iago in Othello, love a bit of Shakespeare. There's from all different corners of theatre, there's many, many roles that I'd love to play.
No small ambitions then.
Maybe. Hopefully more TikTok submissions come up in the future and I can
And
get them that way.
will the whole of your family be coming to Brighton to see you?
Yes, it's funny, most of my family aren't actually from Southeast. It's just my parents happened to move there when they were younger and that's where I've grown up. But
Right.
yeah, all my friends, all my family who do live down there, everyone's piling into the Theatre Royal to see the show. My college have booked a trip to get their musical theatre students in to see it as well. It's going to be that, but I feel like these matinees in Brighton are going to have some really great audiences.
Well, I'm hoping to be able to come along and see the matinee as well as come on press night.
Wonderful.
Because press night, I'll be seeing you in the ensemble, but I'd love to come along and see you actually play the role. I think that would be fascinating. I think it's a wonderful story. It's a great story. about how much talent there is here in South Coast and how many
Well,
great people are going on to play these great roles.
yeah, it's funny you say that. The Dear Evan Hansen TikTok thing. I think there were three or four of us, guys from who were all from Eastbourne who got invited to in-person auditions,
That's
which shocked
extraordinary.
me. I showed up and I knew a couple of the people who were there from home, and they don't they haven't studied musical theatre, or they are and they're living in the southeast. And yeah, it was so there's a wealth of talent down there, and you've got a girl called Ashlyn Weeks who's from Eastbourne, and she's in Starlight Express in the West End. We've
Yeah.
got quite a lot of people from down our way are doing really well at the moment.
Well, listen, thank you for joining me at Latest Television this morning.
Sure.
Best of luck for tonight. I'm sure you'll have a great time in Leicester. And I will see you on stage in a couple of weeks' time at Brighton Theatre Royal.
Thank you very much.